When I'm training sword and shield against an opponent with matching equipment, then training an Oberhaul that strikes with a long edge is a pretty useless action. If you look at Cornelius facing us, as he goes into a ward that looks like many of the miniatures we see from the period, then we see that this part here is well protected. Okay? So there's really no access to the target here. There are actually some wards where you can see the sword point leaning on the shield, so anything that strikes here, the natural line of a blow for a right-hander, there is absolutely no opening. The only quadrant that is most interesting would be this one. So when I'm striking at him, I want to go to the unshielded part of the opponent. So when I'm striking from here, and I start to strike an Oberhaul, at this point here, it's useless to continue on the same path because I will simply strike the shield. So once my blow is developed to this point here, I have to change the angle of attack, which I can by inverting my hand and changing the line of attack so that I can access this unshielded quadrant of my opponent.
This is the core of the movement. In addition to that, I use my fingers to turn it around to get into the reverse grip, and then it all moves forward. I can like throw it forward, and it sort of has a relaxed but occasionally devastating effect.
It doesn't matter if it is struck from over the head. Or from the shoulder, so from our right shoulder, same thing. Or if it was struck from this position here.
What it also does, if Ronald has a shield in his hand, it allows me to go over the shield or pass by the shield like this. As you can see, my sword is closer now to the camera.
Starting position. You see his hand moves to the side. This is crucial to form a barrier in space so that if I strike here, even though he hits me, he's also safeguarded. Yeah?
Which is why we think this is like the common, or one of the standard blows, you could say, in fighting with shields. We used it in one particular situation where one of the fencers was fleeing back into first ward and I'm pursuing from half shield. If I see that he doesn't establish a bind, I can follow with this cut.
Here is that particular strike, which would even work if his shield slips out of the bind. Yeah, so that's why this strike is superior. Okay, good.